So welcome to the course on biometrics. The subject code is CSE 9056. So today I will give you some introduction about the syllabus, and then we will go for the biometrics authentication course. So let me introduce the tentative syllabus. So this is the syllabus of biometrics course. So first we will talk about introduction to biometrics. So there will be a few classes on introduction to biometrics. In introduction to biometrics, we will introduce the biometrics recognition systems or biometrics authentication systems. Then we will introduce biometrics traits. So biometric traits may include face recognition, fingerprint verification, thumbprint verification, and iris recognition. Okay. And then we will talk about the biometrics detection. That means the biometrics traits or biometrics evidences that we capture, like face, fingerprint, thumbprint, iris. So we need to detect the face portion on the or the fingerprint portion from the background. Okay. So when we capture some biometric trait or biometrics evidence, we capture the whole image. Okay. So in that image, the biometrics evidence, is there. So we need to segment the biometrics evidence from the background or background noise. So we will talk about the face detection. So in face detection, we will talk about the detection of face in the image. Then we will talk about the fingerprint detection. Okay. So fingerprint image is captured with background. So we need to segment the background. We need to segment the fingerprint portion from the background, or we need to segment the foreground object from the background noise. And then we will talk about the thumbprint detection or thumbprint segmentation. And finally, we will talk about the iris detection or iris segmentation. Okay. So once we complete the biometrics evidence detection, and then we will go for biometrics fusion. So in biometrics fusion, we will see the sensor level fusion, feature level fusion, score level fusion, rank level fusion, and decision level fusion. But since sensor level fusion, for syllabus, in our syllabus, feature level fusion, score level fusion, and rank level fusion, these three fusions, biometrics fusions levels will be discussed. And this is a few other things on decision level fusion also be discussed, but mainly we will discuss about rank level fusion, feature level fusion, and score level fusion. But we will introduce sensor level fusion and decision level fusion also, and a few other things will be discussed on this two biometrics fusion levels. And we will go for basic image enhancement techniques. Okay. So in basic image enhancement techniques, we will talk about the basic image pre-processing techniques, basic transformation techniques, histogram techniques. Okay. And then we will talk about the low level feature, high level feature. And in the high level feature, we will talk about the sharpening filters. And after that, we will talk about some morphological operations also. If time permits, then we will talk about the morphological operations. Otherwise, the special image enhancement techniques will be discussed. Then in feature extraction techniques, this feature extraction techniques, which is a part of computer vision. So in fundamental computer vision techniques, which are certainly used for biometrics authentication system, which may include EVGM, elastic branch graph matching technique, then principal component analysis, linear discriminant analysis, then shift feature. So shift feature, the full form of the shift feature is scale invariant feature transform, LBP, local binary pattern, okay, MBLBP, then MLBP. So MBLBP, MLBP are a variant of LBP. And then we will talk about LGS, local graph structure. So these are the feature extraction techniques or feature encoding technique, which are used in biometrics authentication. And they are also part of computer vision techniques. Okay. So as a computer vision techniques, we will talk about these feature encoding techniques or feature extraction techniques, which are mainly used for biometrics authentication. They have other usability, but most of the papers, if you review all the papers on biometrics, then you will see most of the works are done based on the this feature extraction or feature encoding techniques. And then as pattern classification techniques, we will talk about linear regression, logistic regression, decision tree, random forest, support vector machine, and Bayesian classifier. If time permits, then we will talk about more machine learning techniques or pattern classification techniques, which are used in biometrics authentication. And lastly, we will talk about the deep learning technique, which is known as convolutional neural network. So many other deep learning models are available, but since this is the convolutional neural network is the first model which was introduced as a deep learning technique, so we will start from this basic deep learning model. Then we will talk about more deep learning techniques if time permits. So these are the sources from which, based on which I have prepared this presentation. If you have any question on syllabus, you can ask me. Otherwise, I will start the introduction. If you have any questions on biometric syllabus, you can ask me. Otherwise, I will go for introduction. So before I talk about identity related issues, so I will introduce what is identity. Okay, so we will talk about little bit about identity, personal identity, then we will go for identity related issues. Okay, so if I ask you what is identity, personal identity, what do you mean by personal identity, then what will be your answer? So what is personal identity?
Sir, it may be Aadhaar card, passport, driving license, like this.
Okay. So if I ask you who are you, then what will be your answer? So when I will ask you who are you, you will tell me your name, your father's name, your mother's name, and where do you live? Okay, and you may talk about your father's profession and your professional degrees. Okay, so all that related information about your identity, that you will be told when someone will ask you who are you. Okay, then if someone will ask you, how do you prove that you are something, you are Mr. X, you are Mr. Y, you are Mr. Z? Okay, so if I ask you how you will prove that you are Mr. Peter, you are Mr. Arjun, you are Mr. something else, then what you have to show about your identity that may establish the connection between you and the related information about yourself. Because personal identity, if we understand about the personal identity related issues, then only we can understand how biometric system works. So before we jump to the biometric systems or the definition of biometric systems, we need to understand what is personal identity and how personal identity attributes are related to someone or some individuals when the personal identity is needed to show in security related issues or security related situation. So when someone will ask you how you will prove your identity, then you will show, you may show Aadhaar card, you may show voter ID card, you may show passport, okay, you may show PAN card, you may show ration card. So these are the surrogate identities about yourself. Okay, surrogate identities, that means these are the token, these are the position based, or it may be position based or knowledge based artifacts. So that will help you to make association with yourself. Okay, so without this surrogate representations, you cannot prove yourself that you are Mr. X, you are Mr. Y, or something else. Okay, so if I ask you who are you, then you will tell me your name, your father's name, your mother's name, and the place you live, okay, and the about your professional degrees. So these are the personal identity related attributes. So all this information are connected to your personal identity. Okay, and if someone will ask you how you will prove yourself that you are Mr. X, you are Mr. Y, or something else, then you will show this knowledge based or position based artifacts or the information that you are having with yourself. Okay, now there are some identity related issues. So what are those issues? So the first issue says that does the applicant have a prior criminal record? Okay, so when someone wants to register for some job or some courses, then before that the authority will check the criminal record of the applicant. Okay, if the applicant is having some criminal record, then he may not be allowed to register for the course, he may not be allowed for the register for the job. Okay, so before register for the job or before apply for the job, the applicant must have the the applicant must have checked for the criminal records. Okay, then it may be questioned that who accessed the bank vault. So bank vault means someone may be trying to access the bank account. So this someone may be some hackers. This someone may be some malicious users. So on behalf of me or on behalf of you, someone may be accessing your bank account. Okay. Now, is the debit or credit card holder is rightful owner? So debit card, you may have the debit card, you may have credit card, but debit card, credit card may be stolen. Okay, may be lost. And someone who will get your debit card, credit card, or the information related to debit card and credit card, then they may access or they may access your account, or they may debit your cash from your bank account also. Okay, so it is necessary to ask the question: is the debit or credit card holder is rightful owner? Okay, now does the voter ID card or ration card applicant already have the same? So here we can have the deduplication condition. Deduplication condition means the one person is having more than one voter ID card, more than one ration card. Then that person will access the that person will access the welfare related fund from the which are issued by the government or which are running by the state government or central government. Okay, so that person will be more benefited than the other individuals because that person is having more than one voter ID card or more than one ration card. Now, does the passport applicant already have the passport? Now, if the passport applicant already have the passport, then that person may travel, or that person may travel more than one. So, in the name of someone else, that person may travel to more than one countries, or where that person may do something some fraudulent activities. So, in the name of the person, the other individual who is using that person may create havoc. Okay, so therefore these are the identity related issues which are needed to solve. Now, what are the different types of credential based authentications? So what are the I will ask you what are the different credential based authentication to authenticate a person or prove the identity of a person, then we can have three choices. The first choice is possession based. That means something you have. Okay, so something you have includes credit card, smart card, driving license, etc. Okay, so these are the possession based credit these are the possession based credentials. Okay, now we can have the knowledge based credential. So knowledge based credential says something you know. So what you know? You may know password, you may know PIN, you may know user ID, you may know mother's maiden name, favorite color, etc. Okay, I'm not talking about the third choice, but let me explain what is position based, what is knowledge based credentials. So position based credentials, that says something you have. So credit card, we most of the most of us are using credit card, smart card, driving license, so all these credentials. But what are the problem? What are the problems with this credential, this position-based credentials? This position-based credentials will not be used after post at the case of post-event recognition. So post-event recognition, what do you mean by post-event recognition? So why you cannot use this position based credentials? So post event recognition means the some criminal activities have happened, okay, or some fraudulent activities have happened. So after that, the person may be missing, may be found missing, okay. So in that case, the position-based credentials may not be useful. Similarly, the knowledge-based credentials, which is something you know, so you may know password. So if you forgot the password, then you need to reset the password, then you can use. Okay. Now, once the so hacker may also try to enter into the system by cracking the password. Okay. If someone else password is having with the hacker, then that hacker may enter into the system by cracking the password. That means the when you use the password for some system or for our mail IDs, so we can we use the very common password like ABCD123. So the combinations are found to be very common. Okay, even in case of debit card pin or credit card password, credit card 4-digit credit card pin. So all these are very common. That means we would like to have the pin like 1234, okay, or 43321, or alternate numbers like 1357. So these are the very common. So hackers are very efficient to crack all these pins or all these passwords. And once the hackers or one malicious once the malicious users enter into the system, then you can he can access all the resources which are having with a system. Okay. So here we can see that the position-based credentials or knowledge-based credentials are not very powerful credentials for authentication or identification. Okay, so we can associate these position-based credentials or knowledge-based credentials with the personal identity. This may be considered as the personal attributes also, and we can establish the relation between personal identity, personal attributes and an individual. Okay, now that individual may have these credentials, but these credentials are not very powerful credentials, because credit card may be lost, credit card may be stolen, okay, password may be forgotten. So pin may be forgotten, user ID may be forgotten. So these credentials are not very useful for biometrics authentication or identification. Now what is the alternative option to authenticate a person or authenticate some individuals? Okay, so we can have the biometrics based credentials. So what is biometrics based credential? So biometrics based credential says that individuals can be identified uniquely. Okay, individuals can be identified uniquely. That means that based on the physiological and behavioral characteristics, a person may be authenticated, a person may be identified. Okay, so that we say something you are, something what you are. Something you are means the biometrics based credential. So biometrics based credentials are based on physiological or behavioral characteristics. So if we consider the physiological characteristics, then physiological characteristics may include face, iris, fingerprint, thumbprint, etc. Okay, and behavioral characteristics include signature, voice, keystrokes. So All these credentials are very much powerful and very much secure credential based authentication systems. Okay, now I have already told you about the disadvantage of position-based and knowledge-based credential systems, but biometrics-based is not 100% correct. Since whenever we design a system, the system may show some errors. Okay, so naturally, biometric system also shows errors, but we represent the errors in the way where we can control the errors by controlling the threshold in verification or identification system. So next we will talk about so next we will see some examples where this position-based and knowledge-based credentials are found to be less secure. Okay, so in case of driving licenses, so yeah, driving license is position-based credentials. Okay, so there are some incident which was happened in USA, where one person when the concerned department scrubbing a driving license, then they saw that one after another, the six there were six images. Okay, so six images were provided in the driving license. Okay, so one person at the same time, the one person was using the six different identities. Okay, so six different identities meant at a time she was using one identity, then any another time she was using another identity. So when the concerned department scrubbing the images, then they saw that this there were six identities. So six different persons are using the same driving license. So this kind of frauds are happening with driving licenses in USA. So here the situation is different. So in India the situation is different. The procedure is different. So therefore here also the fraudulent activities which are related to driving licenses are happening. But since this kind of high-tech systems are not available in India, so only this kind of fraudulent activities are observed or seen in foreign countries or abroad. Now, in passport-related fraudulent activities, Interpol was arrested seven men. Okay, seven men connected to Al Qaeda. So their task was to steal 40 passports per month. Okay, 40 passports per month. So Interpol now has data on 40 million lost or stolen travel documents. Okay, so now you can imagine how passports are not very much powerful credentials for authentication or identification. Okay, so in credit card frauds, JP Morgan says that data belonging to 83 million customers was stolen. So in the year of 2012, when a survey was done by JP Morgan, so JP Morgan saw that there were 83 million customers. The data belonging to 83 million customers was stolen. Okay, and 88% of stolen data used within a minutes. Within a minutes. So now you can imagine that after having after stolen the large number of data related to credit card, 88% stolen data used within a minute. Okay. So another information is very important that says that counterfeit card fraud in the USA amounted to 5.3 billion. Now you can say that 5.3 billion is huge amount, but JP Morgan, the company like JP Morgan, this amount is very less. They consider this amount as a transaction cost, because there is a system, there is a biometric system, there is more secure system like biometrics cryptographic system is available, but they are not interested to install these systems or change the old system with the new biometrics based credential systems. Why? Because changing the system or changing the technology will cost more than 5.3 billion. That is why they see that this 5.3 billion cost as a transaction cost. Okay, changing technology will cost more. That is why they think that this is the cost for transaction. Now in China and South Korea, if you go there, then you will see there is a biometrics ATM, biometrics based ATM machine. Okay, so in ATM machine, what we see? We see there are two layer authentication system. So first we enter the card, then we put the 4-digit pin. Okay, then we press the 4-digit pin, and when you press the 4-digit pin, then we allow to write the amount and all that. Okay, so this is the two layer security system. First we need to enter the card, then we need to press the 4-digit pin, and after pressing the 4-digit pin, then we will be allowed to write the amount, and then we get the money from the ATM. Now if you think this is the most secure, this is the most secure secure system, then this can be also this ATM, in ATM machine credit card may also be stolen. That means the information which is related to credit card may be stolen. Okay, so this is not a very powerful authentication system or secure system. So if we replace this, if we replace the present system with biometric system, then we may have more than one biometric credentials which will be associated with any ATM, any bank ATM. Okay, so that may have multi-layer authentication system. So after authenticated ourselves, then we can get the money from ATM machine. There we can see the biometrics based ATM machine. In biometrics based ATM machine, so first we need to in a fingerprint recognition module, first we need to put our finger. Okay, then we will put our hand on the sensor, and when we will put our hand on the sensor, then through sensor an image is captured, and that image will be matched with the stored image in the ATM machine. Okay, when the match is found to be correct, then only the user will be allowed to get the money from the ATM machine. Now what is the origin of the term biometrics? Okay, so first Morris used the biometrics term in 1875. So biometrics is a combination of two Greek words. Okay, so bios means life, and metron means a measure. So life measure, so measure, or we can say measurement of life. So then in 1981, Pollock asked a question: what makes each person unique? Okay, and introduced biometrics in the context of access control. So in 1888, Francis Galton writes in Nature. So Francis Galton wrote about the biometrics that perhaps the most beautiful and characteristic of all superficial marks are the small furrows with the intervening ridges and the pores that are disposed in a singularly complex yet even order on the undersurfaces of the hands and feet. Okay, so now you can imagine at the time at that so at that time how the Francis Galton imagined about the authentication or identification of individuals with just a small portion or small body portion. Okay, so with this small body portion, someone can be authenticated, someone can be recognized. Okay, so he talked about the ridges and pores on fingerprint. So these ridges and pores on fingerprint, so he saw this ridges and pores may be found to be useful for authentication or identification. That is why he wrote this important phrase in Nature, which was published in 1888. So now you can imagine that biometrics is not a new. Biometrics has been around more than 100 years or more. Now, how the early days of fingerprints were, that means how the fingerprint were looking at the early days. So here we can see that on the left hand side, an image of a fingerprint on a fragment of Palestinian lamp. Okay, so this lamp was made by some artist. Okay, or made by some artist, and when the work was finished, then that artist made an impression of his fingerprint on the work. Okay, so that means that artist was trying to put his identity through a fingerprint, and that fingerprint was made on the work that he made through the scrap, that artistic work that he made. Okay, then the middle of the image you can see a thumbprint on a Chinese clay seal. Okay, then another image is there on the right hand side. A Chinese deed of sale shine with a fingerprint. So all these fingerprint impressions were made after finishing the artwork. If you have any questions, you can ask me. Otherwise, today I will stop here, and in the next class, we will start biometrics authentication system. Okay. If you have any questions, you can ask me. So this was the introduction on biometrics authentication system. So in the next class we will start talking about the components of biometric systems. So till today, if you have any question, you can ask me. Otherwise, we will stop this class now. অভিজিৎ কুমার। पियुष्मा शंकर,
यस सर, अभिजीत कुमार
यस
सर। नो, आई डोंट हैव एनी डाउट।
इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट और इफ यू वांट टू आस्क एनी क्वेश्चन यू कैन आस्क मी नाउ, अदरवाइज वी विल स्टॉप दिस क्लास। In the next class, I will tell about the books that you can study. Okay.
ओके सर, थैंक यू। ओके
And in the next class, we will start the biometrics component. Okay. And little more about biometrics fusion. Okay. Thank you.
थैंक यू सर।
थैंक यू।